people
are we all good?
Is there any more people outside?
Need a bigger room. Apparently the general meeting needs to be in like an auditorium.
Yeah, possibly. Good to go?
Yep.
Alright, I'll just say the opening. Hello, this is ACM. No air horn. Okay. Alright, I think we're about to start.
Hello!
Hello, everyone! This is the first general meeting of the... I need to brew my voice. Hello, everyone! This is the first general meeting of ACM for this semester. Thank you for coming.
So we'll do some short introductions for the new officers this semester before we talk about the actual benefits of ACM because there were drastic changes between last semester and this semester.
Indeed.
Yeah.
So we'll proceed on immediately.
So this is just quick face and name. Hello, I am the new president of ACM for this semester. This is Ryan.
Oh, hi.
This is the vice president.
I forgot who else is on the slide.
You're the one who made them.
I did, but it was last night.
Okay. So we'll proceed down the line.
Lori's not here, but she's the treasurer. Shaw is recording for us.
Thank you very much, Shaw.
But he's the event coordinator.
Then we got Sasan all the way over here. He's our tech talk coordinator for the semester. Then we got Jason, who is currently not here, but he is going to be personal development, basically industry stuff. Then we got Tanvir, which is our club liaison, going and interacting with a bunch of other clubs during the Jason's?
Things
and needs. And then we have Josh, who is our security group coordinator.
We'll
slip on the tongue.
About that
words.
At the next meeting, it's still starting up. We're trying to restart the cyber sig at SACSTATE.
Indeed. And then we have Alan, who is operating. And then we have DLC content. I mean Andrew.
Hi, I'm the DLC content.
He's gonna take his picture.
Indeed. He's our shadow coordinator. We'll talk a little more about shadows a little later. And then our faculty advisor is Dr. Gordon. He's down here in the hall.
I really just included that picture because I wanted three pictures to a slide.
Why did you admit that?
Because it's true.
All right. So before anything else.
Before anybody leaves, because I know some people have told me that they'll be leaving early because they can't really stay for the whole period of time of the meeting. This is important because we will be... This is not the best general meeting time for everybody, probably. It may be, but that's what the poll's for. So next week we'll be having the same general meeting time, but on week 4 forward, we're going to be using the results from this poll to figure out when the best general meeting time will be for the most members. So anybody who has to leave early, note this down and take and fill out this form poll thing later, because it's going to tell us when, or it's going to help us figure out when the best general meeting time will be. And we'll talk more about that later.
Okay. Shadow officers. Would you like to talk about this, Andrew?
I'm ready. Okay. So officers, shadows. Thank you, President. The shadow program for us is a recruitment training program that we have. It will be the way for you to actually become an officer of ATM. We're still looking for new shadows for this semester, and we made a few changes. We decided to bump up the training program a little bit so that you learn exactly what we'll do as an ATM officer. Well, anyone who's interested in becoming a certain type of officer, you can. We're gonna put you under one of these selected officers here, whatever role you would like to be in the ATM. So, if you're interested, just email shadowcoordinator@tsus.atm.org. It'll forward over to me, over to my email. The deadline is February 17th.
That is the end of the fourth week of school.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, anyone who sent emails to me, I'll stop considering emails after February 17th, and I'll be looking at the ones that you've emailed me before.
Yeah, we'll go through an interview process and see if we can get you in as a shadow officer.
Pretty much.
Indeed.
Right. See
you. Membership. Actually, could we skip ahead to what do we do?
Oh, sure.
What do we do? Well, we do a bunch of things involving computer science and computer engineering. Going into the very specific fields, we have tech talks and industry talks, industry being from companies around.
Notably, we had Intel, HP,
Grass Valley.
They're not like a big name, most people don't know them, but they do a lot of stuff in the communication, just the TV stuff.
So basically just pulling in companies that are that specialize in the computer science and engineering fields, seeing what does it take to become to work there, and just get a general feeling of what it is like after we're leaving school and going into the work space. In addition to that, we have a couple of competitions. For this semester, we're trying to do...
We're trying to do several things. We always have the ICPC. We're bringing back the Bud Smash event that we had last semester. It's going to be even better this semester. And then we're trying to do at least one game jam and some other like competition hacking together sort of thing as well this semester.
How many of you guys know what an ICPC is? Okay. So... For those that don't know, it is the, if I get the acronym correct, the Intercollegiate Programming Contest.
International.
It's essentially a competition where people get into groups and solve math problems using using programming. They are math problems. Yes. And then for the game jam we're talking about, it's what's known as a hackathon, which is where another kind of similar, you get into a group and you plan to build something within a certain amount of time. Game jam specifically, it's tailored to making a game within that time period.
But then there's another thing that we'll be doing later in the semester as part of events surrounding Kryptonite and ICPs and things like that where people can just make a cool thing. That'll be figured out more later.
Indeed. But, and then I guess just the kudos of the rest of it is special events and social events, professional events, a lot of events, a lot of pizza. And then field trips. Specifically, this semester we would like to go down to GDC, which is the Game Development Conference, taking place in San Francisco. So we're going to be trying to go together as a group. If you guys are interested, come by us after the meeting and we can talk a little more about that. I think now we can go back to the other one. ACM membership. That is a thing. So unlike other semesters where we've said ACM membership is, if you become an ACM member, you will be getting special perks and benefits. It's more tailored to, we would like to put on awesome events. And this is one of the methods that you guys can help us make them happen, mostly paying for all the things that come into making the events happen. So membership would be $5. A couple of things that would come with it is that for t-shirts you would get a discount, so they would be $10 instead of $15 with membership. Then we also have stoles available to members. This is for if you're graduating, you want to get a special stole that is from us. Around $35, not to sound like a infomercial. Yeah, they are. priority seating.
We're trying not to promise perks here because historically ACM has been really bad at actually providing perks with the membership. So that's why there's not much else after this. Here's the thing that we do know is that at least one event, possibly two, and sometimes general meetings are going to be packed, as you can see here. And so to people who have actually paid the membership, we will soon be setting up an actual door check machine that Ellen made that I don't understand. Will let us actually get members in first so they can have better.
It's to do with
the one thing I know we can do. There are other things we could try, but like we've never actually done other things before.
It's all an experiment. and then there was not much else, but to me that's still a lot of different things. And then join us on OrgSync. That is an optional kind of thing.
They keep complaining that they want people to join us on OrgSync, so I included this because they complain that we don't have people on OrgSync.
They being the sole people. Essentially, they want to track membership by going to OrgSync and just have every person put in their stuff there for our accounts. It is up to you guys if you'd be interested in doing so, but it's not mandatory. And then, next thing? Is there anything?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to show off our nice fancy website.
Take it up, Alan.
So he's going to stand here because he actually has to use a computer. Yep.
So that's our website, csus.atm.org. And here is the poll we were talking about earlier. And you can vote for your times. And you can make multiple votes depending on your time. And then
talk louder.
Huh?
Yell. It's a big room. Yeah.
And if you scroll down to your membership stuff, you can see how to sign up on OrgSync. And this is probably the most important thing on there, which is our newsletter section. And if you don't get our newsletters, you should totally sign up for it. You can sign up for it up here, enter email. It's like once a week. It has all the events that we do on there. And for some reason, if you miss it, you can just click on this and see all of the stuff on there. And if you're not getting it, even after you signed up, it's probably in your spam mail because apparently Gmail doesn't like our website. And I also post all the events on the calendar here too. So it has basic description and time and date, place, officer emails for everyone if you want to get in contact.
And all that stuff.
Yep. And if you want to know more about ICPC or the major events that we do, I sometimes post like what happened at those events at this website. And yep, this is for the kryptonite we might be doing this semester. That's all.
Okay. And then additionally, we may be trying to put this on YouTube since we are recording.
Yeah, we've got a lot of people who can't make our events who are like, hey, do you have a recording of the event or something? So now we record them.
We are trying.
Well, we'll see if it actually worked in about 20 minutes.
Who knows?
Okay. How's that?
And that should be it.
Back there. So anything I need to explain about this that I didn't explain before? So apparently nobody left, which is nice. because that
congratulations for coming.
That means I succeeded in my job in not making the things that we talk about that are completely boring and consequential to actually learning things not take 20 minutes because we're trying to have the drumming times work, not us talking all the time. But yeah, so still there.
So we were okay, so me and Matt were doing a mock interview workshop. It's right behind the
Right behind here.
It's right behind there. So if you've never done a mock technical whiteboard interview and you want practice, me and Matt had some tracking problems that we can help you with what it's like. We've done a lot of interviews between ourselves. So and I think David's helping out too. But yeah, so if you just want to stay behind, we're here till 4. So me and Matt helped with that.
Okay. I think we'll end right there. Any
questions that you have, go ahead and ask us. You can talk to us after the meeting. If you want everybody to hear the question, you can ask them now if you want.
Yes, there are any dates set in stone for the various events for the semester?
Yes. So, didn't know that at the time of the newsletter being sent out Monday, Sunday night, something like that. But we do have some now. So, GDC is, the day the student passes are active for GDC are happening on March 3rd. So that means that the day that we want to actually have our field trips to GDC is going to be March 3rd. That's a Friday. Mm-hmm. Friday of week 5, I think?
Yeah.
Or week 6?
5 or 6.
It's week 6. And then the intended day to have the game jam, assuming we can contact people that we need to contact, will be the day after that, which would be March 4th. That's a Saturday. It'll be several hours long. Other things. Kryptonite, we have a date for, but it's in like 2.5 months, and it's not worth talking about right now.
And then ICPC, that fluctuates with the professors as they assemble all the stuff.
And we're still working on the other events that we'll be having this semester. Those are still in planning.
Okay. All right. Any other questions?
How compatible do you think you can say that this content with somebody who's not a computer engineering or computer science major? I'm a mechanical engineer with a fascination in programming. Do you think this causes them something to offer?
Well, if you're interested in programming, we are definitely going to be trying to cover that in many of our different events. Specifically, just
tech talks. So my job is to find people who have something interesting to present, such as like programming, introduction of programming languages, fun things you can do with anything, basically just interesting stuff. So if you're interested in programming, but you're not a CS or a CP major, it's fine because I got you covered.
Thanks.
Any other questions?
If you wanted to join, it's in a public
contest. Yes, you can.
We will be taking money today, after the meeting, not during. Don't walk up here right now. Anything else?
How about the note that?
Leave early. So, starting this week, several people, hopefully me, I have a lot of people, and we'll be staying in this room, and we will be starting to take money for people's memberships. Is that what your question was about?
Yeah, and also, is there like a membership that's being accessible to everybody?
No, there is not.
Is there a reason why?
Is there a reason why I should?
We keep records. Okay, that's good.
That's good.
And one more thing, also, on the website, is accessible to and what class?
I believe we're going to try to talk to some of the tutors near the mid and end of the semester and see if we can get those on there as well.
Are you talking about the CS, the tutoring put on by the department, or like
any type of course?
So, actually, Shaw, you want to talk about your fancy thing?
Okay, so I'm setting up this thing called FlexPage. We'll have every class offered by the computer science department in there. So, the more people we have in there, the more resources you'll have to get help from. Spread the word. I'll have the link up there later. And hopefully I'll have some professors joining in there also to help out. Let's see how this goes. It's still an experiment. Slack is industry-level software. Use it at work, at hackathons. You'll see it more often. So, you know, if we have GitHub integration, a whole bunch of other stuff we can talk about, let me know.
So it's a giant Slack with all the courses, and basically if you have a question on one of the courses, you just go to that channel, you ask your question, and then hopefully someone will answer it. We just made it this semester, so it won't have that many people. Yeah. So,
lots of experiments.
But is that the
yeah, so... Yeah, so if you sign up for... If you go onto Slack and you're looking for a team... You would type this in, including the hyphen. And then you just make an account with it.
Or you can just walk into this room when there's no class and just ask around if you need help. People are always in here when there isn't a class.
Do we have the availabilities for this semester? Which days people can come in?
Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then Tuesdays and Thursdays. This room is basically always full, but this room is basically completely empty on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays.
Except for like,
I think there's one class. That
there's one class at like 10 a.m. to 11.
It's unconsequential. Wakes up before 10 a.m.
All right. Any other questions?
Marco, again. Yeah, I didn't fully get that. Will there be like a sheet on the door?
Yes.
Yeah, we're trying to figure out what classes are there, and then we're gonna put it on the door.
Is it possible for other lab rooms?
We're the ones who put that out there because it's not ECS who does that. If you want that in other labs, you'll have to request that from ECS themselves. The tech department on the second floor, not the dean's office.
Okay. Anything else? Mm-hmm.
This might be something you're already about to tell us, but when is your next general meeting? I want to tell us about
the club.
So, I said it earlier, but some people might have missed it because I talk sort of fast sometimes. Next week, we'll be having the same general meeting time as we did this week, and then the week after that is when we're switching over to the general meeting time as determined by the poll.
Will you start verifying if people are members at the second meeting after the time's established, or will you start verifying if people are members like the next meeting afterwards, for the seating at least?
That's a great question. I don't know yet.
Fair enough.
Is the thing you just cash only or SD card yet?
So I don't know if campus has changed its rules on this, but the last I checked, campus doesn't actually allow people to use card on campus for club stuff.
Yeah, so cash at the moment. Okay. Thank you very much for coming. If you have any questions or you'd like to sign up or anything, we're going to be over here. Give us. Okay, we need to delegate to someone. So, Alan.